Hi there. In this video, I'm going to talk about eye tracking. So first of all, I really would like to thank Alexandra Papoutsaki, who is lead coordinator for the WebGazer project that I'm going to talk in a minute. And so what are we going to talk about today? I'm going to talk about eye tracking and the concern that I have with eye tracking. So eye tracking refers to the eye movement that you can track of given users in order to understand what's going wrong about a specific project that you launched. If you look for open source eye tracking technology, you will find many on the internet, such as PyGaze, such as Pupil Labs, and other things like that. But the main issue that I personally have is that actually they are not accessible at all, as you can see. The entrance price for the hardware, and I'm not even sure that this is only the hardware, maybe that's the software linked to it as well, but just the entry cost is very high in terms of hardware in all cases. And what I really like with WebGazer is that, as they are saying it here, the thing is to democratize eye tracking through the use of webcam, which is the tool that everyone has. I really like as well that in WebGazer what they have is an easy way to install the software. So in order to access to WebGazer, so typically WebGazer is a technology that you can embed on your website, which will use the webcam of your visitor in order to know how the eyes are going on the website. So you just need to click on the GitHub link. Here you will see the license, which is interesting as it's in a LGPL license, the one that you can see over here. Oops. And yes, so you have instructions in order to install it, which are, when I try to install it, a bit incomplete. So this is where once more I thank Alexandra, who really helped me a lot defining new instructions. So in order to install WebGazer, what you need to do is that you need to download it, then you need to install Node.js, then you need to install Node.js, then you need to install Grunt. Once you do so, you need to go within the repository that you downloaded, so you need to access to it by doing a cd www. Once you are within your repository, you need to run npm, which will then install everything that you have up here. And then you need to launch a web server. This web server can be either launched through Browser Sync or can either be on Python. So that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm just going to show you how it works. So I have my full directory that I put over here, so it's WebGazer and WebGazer. So this is all the files which are coming from GitHub, and in order to launch the given WebGazer, I need to go on cd www. Okay, so now I'm on cd www, where I have the different HTML file on which I embed the different scripts. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to launch empty.html. I'm just going to access to this one, which is the file that Alexandra just created for me with only the scripts which are needed in order to launch WebGazer, basically because you can do a lot of things with WebGazer, and there are many different scripts that you can add. In their website, which is fully documented, they're explaining that you can even use it to track search engine results, but also in order to play with some kind of game, from what I understood. So let's go back over here. So now I need to launch my Python script. So I'm just going to go over here, my Python server, sorry. So it's probably this one. I'm gonna launch. So go over here and I'm launching it. Yep. So I need to launch it as case as sudo. Okay, so here's telling me blah blah blah. Okay, so probably that's because I just need to have this one first, and then I'm all good. So I can launch it. So now it has been launched on port localhost 8000. So localhost 8000. Okay, got it. And then empty .html. Okay, so the first thing which is gonna happen is every time that you connect to a page which have the script on, it's gonna ask you to have your webcam on. So okay, so that's what. So this is my face, and then from my understanding, in order to have it accurate, you need to calibrate it, and it goes by clicking at some specific points of your web page. So you have a full file explaining how this full thing is working, and then once the calibration is done, then it means that, for example, now if I look at the top right and corner of my website, as you can see, the webcam is recognizing it. So now I'm gonna go at the, let's say my eyes are gonna go at the bottom left hand corner, and as you can see, oh, the calibration is not good over here. Like so, now if I'm doing it, you will see that the red cursor is going in this direction. Same thing if I'm going back, top right hand corner, or even at the top, right hand corner. Okay, so this part's not gonna help you much because that's a blank page. So what I did is I designed another page which is gonna be Dogger. Okay, and that's my page. So this is the let's imagine that this is a website. Okay, so I just created it for the sake of this example. So imagine that you had kind of a button like this on which you say, okay, I want to help you improve your website, and people could click on it and then could ask, it could explain actually what you intend the users to do. So you could explain, okay, I'm gonna launch an eye tracking software, do you agree with it? If you agree, please add your webcams on and give your authorization, and like this we will know how you are browsing our website in order to know if the website is properly designed. So I'm gonna do exactly the same thing as I did. So I'm gonna click here, I'm gonna click here, I'm gonna click here as well, I'm gonna click here as well. So now normally it has been properly calibrated, so whatever the place I'm gonna look at, it's gonna be kind of accurate, and it's kind of interesting because, as you can see, whatever the place I'm currently looking at, okay, like this dog or this dog, then I know in fact how my eyes are moving on the website. So unfortunately, this software WebGazer is not coming with a software in order to tell you what are the coordinates at which people are looking at, but Alexandra gave me a nice trick. So in fact, if you look through the console, you will see the different, in fact, coordinate at which the cursor is moving on and on with all the different timestamps. And so this is on the client, but thanks to the script that we just launched, it should record properly the logs with the different coordinates of the X and Y in order for you afterward to, let's say, use back those given coordinates in order to use them for heat map. And this is what I showed in another video where I explain you how you can easily take those different coordinates X and Y in order to plot them on a map like the one that we're gonna see. Yep. Like this, and you will see as a result how people are in fact looking at your website thanks to the X and Y coordinates that they just looked out. And that's it for today. So I really hope that this small video helped you understand a little bit more about eye tracking, how it works, and give you a good idea of what WebGazer can do for you. So the best piece of advice I can give you is, let's say, to try to install it and try to play with it, because in my case I just spent a couple of hours, not that much, in order to see the let's say the basic scripts. But I give you in fact the raw material in order for you to already start to have it working, and now you can dig a little bit more into depth in order to move forward and maybe use it more in a professional environment. Thanks for watching.